If you're looking to add a lot of variety to your short game, in today's video, I'm going to show you how to do that, in particular, with your chippy. So I like to keep the chipping relatively simple, but still give you the ability to adjust your trajectory and or your spin rate as you work yourself around the green and you learn some basic chip shots. So I got this from watching James Ridyard. James, a phenomenal short game coach. He's probably one of the best in the world. If you get a chance, follow him on social media or hit his website, and I'll put those links down below. I really like the work that he's doing, and how can you not when he's producing such good chipping instruction. So one of the things that you can do is you would go ahead and you would take about a comfortable stance, feet, let's say they're under your hips. And what you're going to do is you're going to place five balls on the ground like this. Okay, you can use a club to line them all up, make sure they're flush to one another. And you would have your first ball would be equal to your left big toe or your left instep. And the last ball would be equal to your right big toe or instep. So the middle ball is the one we're going to focus on, and that one's going to give you your stock shot. Okay, that's the one that you would hit probably most often with any particular club. It's going to give you a certain trajectory and a certain spin. And when you do that, you're going to set up, the shaft is going to be relatively vertical, meaning it's going to be pointed just about to the button on your pants, your belt buckle, your zipper, your sternum, whatever you want to use as a guide. And you're just going to have a simple turn back and turn through. And when you do that, you're going to find out that when you make your turn through and you face the target, that the shaft or the butt end is still pointed at your button on your pants, your belly button, your zipper, again, whatever you selected to use as a measurement. If you wanted to hit a ball a little lower, obviously you can move the ball back in your stance. So we'll take the one that's one back. You're going to move a little bit closer to the ball, and because the shaft comes up, it's going to open the face slightly, and I'll put a link to my video where I illustrate that down below. So what you're going to have to do is close the face a little bit, okay? The butt end of the club still pointed to the belt or button on your pants, which means you have a little bit of a shaft lean, and you go ahead and you basically make the same movement, and this time what happens is when you make your turn, the butt end of the club is going to be pointed closer to your lead pant pocket or your outside pocket, however you want to describe it, okay? If you want to hit the ball a little bit higher, you would obviously use a little bit further forward ball position. You're going to have a slight negative shaft angle, meaning it's leaning slightly away from the target. Again, always the butt end pointed to the button on your pants. You're going to not move the butt end as much, but the head's going to move quite a big distance in relationship. So negative shaft angle, okay? A lot of club head movement, not a lot of hand movement. And you still move and rotate towards the target. And you'll notice when I make that move, that the butt end of the club is pointed to my trail hip pocket, okay? So if I were to face the camera, if I were to do my stock ball position, okay, made my normal motion, you'll notice that the butt end, again, to the belt buckle or the button of my pants. If I'm going to hit it lower, the ball is going to go back, slightly forward ball position, a little closer, close the face, same movement, the butt end of the club pointed to my lead pocket, and if I want a little higher, the ball goes a little further forward. I have a bigger path for the club head, less for the hands, and when I follow through, that butt end is going to be pointed at my trail pocket. So that's a lot of information. Give it a little bit of practice. Go out to the putting green or your chipping green at your local club. Give those things a try. I'm sure in a short amount of time, you're going to notice a big, big difference in your chipping. You're going to have a lot more variety and a lot more fun on the golf course in the process. Hey everybody, thank you for watching another one of our videos. We hope you picked up something that's beneficial to your game. If you tried what we just gave you today, love to hear about it. Post it in the comments below. Don't forget to click subscribe. We'd love to have you as a follower. You can also hit us up on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter under The Golf Paradigm. And don't forget to follow the hottest podcast in golf our podcast called Golf 360. If you'd like to subscribe or watch some more of our videos, you can do so right over here.